Stress. We have all been there, feeling anxious, irritable, and helpless. Stressful situations are just a part of daily life, from your job to deciding what you're going to have for dinner. We are rarely without stress. Even in a relaxing bath, an irritating thought about all the things you have to do the next day might pop into your head. A small amount of stress can be useful and even motivational, but too much can feel out of control and take toll on your mind, body, and relationships. A study showed that long-term stress can actually change your genetic structure and lead to a lot of health issues. Today, we're going to help you learn 14 ways of dealing with stress in the right way. Listen carefully because these tips will help make sure you don't burn out or turn to quick fixes, which can lead to addiction. You'll even find some of the helpful things you think you are doing are not really that helpful at all. Stress is a fast spiral you don't want to take a ride down. So let's get into it. Number 14, put on some music. Stressful situations can make you feel stuck or overwhelmed, so it really helps to take a break and listen to some relaxing music. Research shows that calming music or nature sounds have a relaxing effect on your brain and body. It can help lower your blood pressure and cortisol, which is a stress hormone. Lots of platforms like YouTube, Spotify, and Apple Music have readily available calming playlists you can listen to. Number 13. Laughter is the best medicine. When you're feeling overwhelmed, the last thing you want to do is laugh. But laughter is exactly what you need. Laughing will flood your nervous system with feel-good endorphins that will instantly improve your mood and decrease your stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline. Start by laughing, no matter how forced it feels. In no time at all, you'll find that you are genuinely laughing and tricking your brain into making you feel good. You can also try watching some stand-up comedy, listening to a funny podcast, or watching one of your favorite comedy films. Number 12. Find a voice of reason. Talking about your stress can help you break it down and work through it. This is because people outside of your situation can be reassuring, help shine a new light on things, and give you a more grounding perspective. When you feel stressed, it is easy to catastrophize, blow things out of proportion, and jump to the worst conclusions, which only intensifies the stress, like assuming you'll be fired or that your relationship is over. In most cases, this is just not true, and even if it is, there are always productive steps you can take to resolve them or move forward. Talking to a friend can help you find the voice of reason. If talking to someone else isn't an option, then talking calmly to yourself, as if you were offering advice to your loved ones, is the next best thing. That might seem crazy, but it's better than actually being driven crazy with stress. Number 11. Nourish your brain. When people feel stressed, they either eat too much or forget to eat at all. And both of these things can cause more stress, because your diet is closely linked to how you are able to function. Try to resist the urge to pick up quick fixes like sugary or fatty snacks and junk food. Instead, plan ahead and pick foods packed with nutrients like fruits, vegetables, and fish rich in omega-3. These foods have actually been shown to reduce stress levels, so it will benefit you to pick healthier options. Why not take the time to make a tuna sandwich? It'll give you a well-deserved break and feed your brain. Number 10. Cut the caffeine. It's easy to reach for the caffeine when you're under pressure and feel like you have to focus, stay up, and find energy. Stress uses up all your energy in a short space of time, so that in itself is exhausting. But those large caffeine doses are actually spiking your blood pressure and heart rate, which make you feel even more stressed. The best thing you can do is go for a green tea instead. It has half the caffeine of coffee and energy drinks, and it's full of healthy antioxidants which will help you calm down and think clearly rather than erratically. Number 9. Move your body. Another great way to give your brain a boost of endorphins is exercise. It doesn't have to be anything time-consuming or intense like powerlifting or suddenly running a 5K. It can just be star jumping for a minute, a nice stretch, or a short walk to the toilet. This small break and the release of endorphins from getting your body moving will give you an instant mood boost. Number 8. Get some sleep. At one point or another, we have all laid awake at night losing sleep over worry. But lack of sleep makes us less focused, functional, and ultimately contributes to stress. It can be a frustrating, vicious cycle that seems impossible to get out of and only gets worse with time. The only way to improve this is by being consistent and disciplined with your sleep hygiene. Turn off all screens early, dim the lights, and limit stimulation so you feel relaxed before going to bed. You can try to read a book, listening to relaxing music, or a meditative podcast. Avoid checking the time, even if you feel like it's getting really late. Looking at the clock and calculating how many hours you might get again and again will just make you anxious and, therefore, awake. A bad sleeping pattern builds over time, so you need to accept that a good one will take time too. Getting 7 to 9 hours of sleep is one of the most effective things you can do to combat stress. Number 7. Watch your vices. Getting quick fixes and immediate gratification are easy to justify when you feel stressed. I worked really hard, so I deserve a cigarette and a glass of wine to wind down. Using these tactics to drown your stress in wine, cigarettes, food, or any other vice is an instant release because you are, understandably, craving endorphins. Endorphins are great, but unhealthy vices can counteract this and be damaging long term when one glass of wine turns into one every night, then a bottle, and so on. In this way, unhealthy vices end up adding to your stress over time once those small bursts of endorphins have worn off. As well as addictions, they contribute to the negative effects stress is already having on your body, like increased blood pressure and sleepless nights. Everyone has unhealthy vices. Just make sure you are not making a habit of turning to them every time you feel stressed. Number 6. Counter techniques. You are what you think. If you think negatively and self-critically, you'll feel negative and are more likely to fail. This is self-sabotaging, and you need to remember that just because you think something is true, it doesn't mean it is. Instead, challenge those negative thoughts by fact-checking yourself and reframing them in a realistic or meaningful way, rather than trying to be excessively positive. For example, a worrying thought might be, "I'm going to mess up this important pitch." A purely positive and unhelpful reframe would be, "I'm amazing, it will all go smoothly and everything will be fine." But a realistic and helpful reframe is, "I know a lot about my pitch and I can take more time to practice. One or two things might go wrong, but most people won't even notice." Number 5. Inhale, exhale. Being told to take a deep breath might seem silly, but clichés are clichés for a reason. It really does work. When we feel stressed and anxious, it manifests physically with palpitations, sweating, or shallow breathing, which is really uncomfortable and can cause more distress. You can easily counteract this by taking some deep breaths to oxygenate your blood and take that stress out of your body. You don't have to be into meditation or yoga to utilize this. Just take the time to breathe. You can try this easy method. Sit up with your back straight, feet flat on the floor, and your hands on your knees. Concentrate on breathing in slowly and deeply as much as you can, making sure your lungs are fully expanded. Then breathe out again slowly and deeply till your lungs have retracted. Do this for 3 to 5 minutes, or however long you need to, and we guarantee you will feel noticeably more calm and centered. Number 4. Focus on things you can control. It is absolutely pointless to worry and stress about things beyond your control, because what will be, and whether you like it or not, there's nothing you can do about that. You simply have to accept the things you can't change. Similarly, if you start getting caught up in the fear of uncertainty, you need to shift your focus to the things you can control. Things won't always go your way, and that's just life. You have to keep moving forward. For example, if your workplace is making redundancies, then being stressed will not solve the problem or change your situation. You have to stop wasting time and look for a new job. Even the act of taking control is inherently empowering, and it is a critical element of finding solutions that are suited to you and not someone else. Number 3. Work smarter, not harder. If you feel like you never have enough time and you are overwhelmed with work, it might be time to take a look at how you are working. Restructuring the way you work takes time, thinking, and organization. It can feel like a big task in itself, but once you start working smarter, you'll find that everything immediately becomes more efficient and less stressful. By taking the time to get organized, you'll set yourself up for success. Look at how you manage your time by allocating slots to specific tasks without other distractions and set realistic deadlines. If a task seems daunting, split it up into smaller steps which are easier to tackle. When you know you have big days coming up, plan ahead with a to-do list, packing list, and plan your journey so there are solutions before you have even encountered problems. Number 2. Confront your problems. Taking time out is crucial for your mental well-being and preventing burnout. But if you start doing this in excess, it becomes counterproductive to self-care and another source of stress instead. Be mindful that you are not meeting a friend or running a bath every time you feel stressed as an avoidance tactic rather than a deserved break. Take time to clear your mind if you need to, but make sure you always come back to tune into the stress and actually manage it by establishing a constructive, tangible, organized, and efficient working system. It's easy to bury your head in the sand or justify time out, but if you ignore things, they will only get bigger. And you can't run away forever. Number 1. Schedule stress and me time. When you feel stressed and out of control, a routine can feel comforting and have other benefits like improving your diet and sleep. It can be allocated time in the day just for you, and when things get overwhelming, you can look forward to it as a relaxing break to tune out the stress. It can be reading a book in the bath, listening to your favorite podcast on your commute to work, or a daily walk. If you take the time to create a realistic and well-balanced schedule with work, breaks, fun activities, and sleep, you can compartmentalize stresses and worries to relevant parts of the day and use that time to work on them. Be careful not to let the schedule rule you. It should be flexible to work around your needs, not another source of stress. So there you have it, 14 ways to deal with stress. Stress, like death and taxes, is just an inevitable part of life. And although it has the potential for serious physical and mental health issues, our tips will help you manage it in the right way. All you need is some patience and consistency to reduce stress, whether that's in the workplace, with your family, or at school. Remember, you have the power to help yourself be more efficient, develop healthy coping mechanisms, prevent burnout, and avoid avoidance. What was your favorite tip? Is there anything stressing you out at the moment? We would love to know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and we'll be back soon with more great content. In the meantime, you can check out our other amazing self-help videos.